All right, the latest news break that we are getting in right now from Israel. There has been a fresh wave of explosions that have been reported in northern Israel. Missiles have been fired at Israel. Let's quickly cut across to Gaurav Sabat.
We are barely a couple of kilometers away from the Israel-Lebanon border in northern Israel. And this is one of the kafars or the villages or kibbutz that is being cleared out, and people are being asked to move to safer areas. We are just being told that we are supposed, as they can hear, apparently there is some movement that is happening. There are people rushing into their homes. We are also trying to rush into their home right now. So situation here is extremely tense. Let me now try and show. This is the house. This is a safety door that has been shut. This is a door that's completely been shut down now as soon as the sirens were heard. And with a family, sir, once the siren goes off, this is a specially reinforced door that you've shut?
Yes, of course. It's good. So it's heavy. Good. It's good heavy. It's a good door.
Good door. And I'm so glad you still have a beautiful smile on your face, beta. What's your name?
Michaela.
So it's good. You know, anybody else would have been extremely scared the moment you hear siren. But they're growing up, they hear this often.
Every time, every day. It's very hard for them.
It's hard for them, but I notice you also have, and I want to show you this house. So it has a specially reinforced all metal door, all metal frame inside this door that's been shut. Ventilation point completely shut. What is that in that corner? That is an
This is special.
זה משאבה ידנית להוציא...
מנואלה כזאת.
זה כזאת מנואלה שאני מושך. וזה כאילו...
It's manual pump to take the gas or...
Yeah.
Outside from the room. Okay. In case of a...
And I also noticed that this is a reinforced window. Specially reinforced window.
Yeah,
this cannot break with splinters. So it's almost like a bulletproof glass in this room. The air conditioning is on, reinforced concrete, and well, the little child now is switching on the television. The grandmother also in the house. Namaste, how are you?
Fine.
I'm good, thank you.
Nice to have you.
Thank you very much. And in these circumstances, in your house, and you've got your phone on already. So this what life is like right now in Israel. And how far are we from, sir? How far are we from the Lebanese border right now? 15 kilometers. So the moment that rocket is fired from that side, how much time do we have here?
We need 15 seconds.
15 seconds.
Seconds.
Just 15 seconds.
Yes. Just 15 seconds.
So it takes, you have only 15 seconds to run to this shelter. This is the bomb shelter in this house. It's actually a very well constructed bomb shelter which has specially reinforced concrete walls. Usually if walls are around 2 brick strength, which is about 9 inches here, it's more than 4 brick strength.
Yes.
It's so
I think 20 centimeters.
20 centimeters. 20 centimeters is the thickness of the wall. Bulletproof glass, specially reinforced. Of course, they have air conditioning, you know, for oxygen to be resupplied and for fresh oxygen to come in. There's machine, and it's also done manually. Because if you recall, when Hamas terrorists had attacked southern Israel last time, though most houses have this mamad, as it's known as, or this special constructed bomb shelter, they really have to ensure to stay here for several hours. You have food, you have water, you have snacks, you have television, and also power backup till the time security reinforcements can come in. But you're unfortunately always living in harm's way. Gaurav Sawant in northern Israel for India Today.
Right. Israel clearly now fighting a multi-front battle. Israel continues its operations against Hezbollah and its attack on Lebanon. Thick smoke blanketed Lebanon as Israel launched rockets. In the latest, Israel claimed that the head of Hezbollah's executive council and potential successor to Hassan Nasrallah, Hashim Saifidin, has died in an airstrike in the southern suburbs of Beirut. Israeli ground operations in southern Lebanon this week followed 2 weeks of intense airstrikes and bombardment. Israel claims it has killed over 250 Hezbollah members, including top commanders. Meanwhile, Iran has issued a warning to Israel that it may target Israel's energy plants and facilities if need be. Now, in midst of all the suspense over Israel's next move against Iran, satellite images show that Iran moved its tankers and oil vessels from the oil rigs in Kalg Island. Meanwhile, Hezbollah has released a video of Israeli post targeted in Palestine. All right, let's quickly move on in the bulletin right now. India Today's Gaurav Sawant has been reporting relentlessly from northern Israel, a place which is being constantly targeted. Listen in.
Some of the abandoned towns in northern Israel, people only return here during the day to check if all is well, if their homes are okay, if they weren't bombed the previous day, check if everything's around in the neighborhood, and then go back by evening to... Currently in Akko, in the northern part of Israel. This is about an hour's drive from Haifa in northern Israel, and this is one of the worst impacted areas. Whether it's Galil a little ahead or Metula, these are areas that are directly in the line of Hezbollah fire. Rocket attacks have happened just a short while back, and if you look all around, this place is virtually abandoned. A very, very bustling tourist town. This is virtually abandoned. This, of course, is the Arab quarter here. There are some men, of course, who are still staying behind. Most of the women and children have been sent to a safer area. The men are staying behind so that they can look after their property. They can look after this area. This, if you looked right behind me, this is the lighthouse of Akko. This is the Mediterranean Sea just behind me. And just beyond, as the crow flies, barely 6 to 8 kilometers as the crow flies, is the area where the Lebanese forces in southern Lebanon are targeting this area. So we're directly in the line of Lebanese fire. And with me right now is Shlomi Haskell. And Mr. Haskell, if I may, Mr. Haskell is somebody who lives here in Haifa, has been living here for quite some time. He's a former Israeli Navy officer. Sir, what can you tell me about the current situation here?
Now the situation, it's very bad. All the people stay at home, don't go outside. Actually, Saturday morning, hundreds of people go to restaurant and traveling. Nobody here. The street and the road, it's empty.
How?
5-7 kilometers from here, nothing from here. It's Lebanon border between, this is the border between Israel and Lebanon. We're gonna see there, and we're gonna be there in a few minutes. Then we'll see what happens.
And the situation here also remains very tense.
Very, yeah.
People are leaving their homes and going to safer areas.
Yeah, it doesn't go outside at all.
So that's the situation right now. People are leaving this area. They're going to safer areas. If you look around, it's a very beautiful touristy part of Israel. It's an ancient city. Haifa, anyway, as you know, is a historic city. India and Haifa have a First World War connection. We'll talk about that in greater detail subsequently. But right now, there's clear and present danger of an addition of more missile strikes that are likely to take place in this area as Israel intensifies its operations against Lebanon, against Hezbollah in southern Lebanon. Some of the abandoned towns in northern Israel, people only return here during the day to check if all is well, if their homes are okay, if they weren't bombed the previous day, check if everything's around in the neighborhood, and then go back by evening to safer locations. And they've been living like this since the 8th of October 2023. Life extremely tough for people in northern Israel, directly in the line of Hezbollah fire. And this is exactly why the government says their aim is to go into southern Lebanon, eliminate Hezbollah strongholds, missile and rocket launch sites, to ensure those 70,000 people can return home. Right behind me is a military police checkpoint near Agziv in Rosh HaNikra area. And Rosh HaNikra is the northernmost tip of Israel, beyond which is Lebanon. And this is where India Today is reporting from ground zero. The heart of tension between Israel and Lebanon right now begins from this area. And let me once again try and explain how important this area is right now. Israeli forces are moving in from this area. As you see beyond this checkpoint, you have some military vehicles that are parked here. And beyond this is a military area. You cannot, no civilians can go beyond this point. From there, forces are now making inroads into southern Lebanon, trying to secure this flank from the Hezbollah terrorists. This is how sensitive this area is, where we are reporting from the northernmost tip of Israel, from where operations against Lebanon are currently being undertaken. The situation here remains extremely tense. All the way from here down to Haifa, this entire belt is in the line of Hezbollah rocket and missile fire. And even as we speak, as you see behind me, there are multiple military vehicles that are going towards the border area. And because it's a military sensitive military zone, we are told you should leave this place as quickly as possible, because this is the time that rocket attacks usually begin. Mr. Haskell, how sensitive is the area where we are right now?
Now we are staying no more than 3 kilometers from the northern point. After that, it's the border between Lebanon and Israel. Actually, you see it's very quietly, nobody here. The road is empty. The military parent, they don't let us go more than that. And we stop here. We try to see the view from there, but we cannot go there right
now. And right now, when we look at this area, why this becomes very sensitive? Because it's from there that Hezbollah is firing its rockets. The rockets are even falling where you and I are standing right now. So I was told
it can happen.
Anytime, anything can happen. I was told by the army that you wear your bulletproof jacket immediately.
All right, let's cut across right now. My colleague Gaurav Savan joins us from North Israel, where just a short while back, missiles were launched from Lebanon. I also have Ashraf Wani reporting from Beirut, Lebanon. Rajesh Pawar, one of the very few journalists who's been reporting from Tehran, Iran. All three of them join us, but I want to cut across first to my colleague Ashraf Wani. Ashraf, the latest that is coming in is that there has been a fresh missile attack on North Israel by Lebanon. What more can you add?
Priti, this is not the first time during last 4 days, particularly after the assassination of Sayyid Hassan Nasrallah. On daily basis, 150 to 200 rockets Hezbollah is firing towards the northern parts of Israel. It is the target, it was the target that is the northern part of the Israel. And today also they have launched the barrage of rockets towards the area where currently Gaurav Savant is, and also in the Haifa port, where some of the rockets were diffused by the Iron Dome system of Israel, and also to the Safed Tower. Safed Tower is on the target of the Hezbollah, because that is the way which heads towards the southern part of the Lebanon. And there is ground invasion already of the Israeli forces. So to prevent them to head towards the southern borders and southern Lebanon, the Hezbollah has adopted this strategy to attack more and more those contingents of army which are heading towards the southern part of the Lebanon for operations. As far as the situation here in the Lebanon is concerned, it was only south part of this country which was on target of the IDF. Now, since yesterday evening, we are seeing that the central and the eastern parts of Lebanon are also being targeted by the warplanes of the IDF, and even in Tripoli, a Palestinian refugee camp was targeted, in which one of the commanders of Hamas, Qassam Brigade, with his family was killed, and also a massive damage in that building in Tripoli, which was considered as safe area. In the south Beirut, there are timely air missiles being fired by the warplanes of Israel, and also in the southern villages of the southern Lebanon, here in the Lebanon.
All right, Ashraf, stay on with me. Let's cut across right now to all the ground reports that my colleague Ashraf has filed from the Syrian border in Lebanon.
I'm currently in the south Beirut, and after the more than 200 blasts during Thursday night, on Friday night there was another series of aerial strikes in this area of Dahiya district in south Beirut. Behind me, this is a multi-story housing colony, and each and every apartment of this particular area has been targeted during the Friday night. And on the Saturday morning, you can see what is the condition of this whole colony. There was no one except some of the Hezbollah fighters who were targeted in this housing apartment. And there are reports of more than 25 people had been killed in these attacks here in the southern suburb of Beirut. There is not any kind of a pause from the Israeli Air Force in attacks on Lebanon. Now these aerial attacks and missile strikes had went to different areas of Lebanon, with South Lebanon now in the east also, and in the central Lebanon too. There is fear more than 2 million people from Lebanon have already displaced from this spot. Ashraf Fani for India Today in south suburb of Beirut.
I'm currently exactly at that part of the highway which connects Beirut city with the Damascus, and it also joins the two countries, that is Lebanon with Syria. And this is the only road from which during last many weeks more than 2 million people have already crossed to Syria for finding any safe place there to live, because there is so much threat for life in the southern parts of Beirut as well as in the south part of Lebanon, where currently ground invasion of Israeli forces is going on. Now you can see the condition of this highway. You may see how much deep this cut has got formed due to the missile strike. In fact, 25 feet deep hole created by that missile strike. It was created by the Israeli Air Force by air bombing this highway, and both the necks of this axis of this road had been completely damaged, and it is not able for any motor vehicle to pass through highway. Now what the people who get displaced from this area are doing, they just move by foot and cross this point here and by foot, and then take the other vehicle from other side of the road. You can see how the people are coming here with their luggages, bags, whatever they have, and moving by foot
from that side, which is walkable, and then crossing towards the Syria. And this road IDF claims was not only used by the people who get displaced from Lebanon, but also is a main pipeline and lifeline for Hezbollah. Ashrafani, for India Today, on Damascus Beirut Road on border of Lebanon.
Meanwhile, India Today's Rajesh Pawar is in Tehran, Iran. Take a look at this report.
Yesterday, while addressing a big rally attended by hundreds of thousands of Iranian people, Ayatollah Khamenei, the leader of Iran, has actually challenged Israel that if Israel tries to do something to Iran, then the retaliation will be very heavy. But can Iran do that? Can Iran take on Israel? Maybe yes, but it probably will not be Israel alone. It will be the combined might of America and Israel probably, which will attack Iran. And in that case, will Iran be able to face off this kind of attack? Nobody knows for sure what kind of arsenal Iran has, the quantity they have, the quality of weapons they have, because the kind of hypersonic missiles which Iran claims to have, whether they actually have it, will they work it or not, it is yet to be seen. But the confidence of people here, confidence of the leadership of Iran, seems to be quite determined that in case Israel attacks Iran, then the retaliation from Iran's side will be very heavy, and they will be able to wipe out Israel from the face of earth. This is Rajesh Pawar from Tehran, Iran, for India Today.
Meanwhile, India Today has spoken exclusively with ambassadors of Iran, Israel and Lebanon. Listen in to what they say.
You know, Israel does not understand, is not committed to the international law. It has proven that it is not committed to international law. Genocide in Gaza has shown and proved to the people that Israel do not pay any attention to the human principle, ethics. So it just understand the language of force.
So they might
Israel did not see anything in front of itself. It occupies Lebanon, in south Lebanon, even in Sabra and Shatila, inside Beirut, capital of Lebanon. They killed too many people in Sabra and Shatila camps. But when Hezbollah appeared, when Hezbollah got enough strength to push them back, they withdrew their forces from Lebanon and they went back. Of course, still there are some parts of territory of Lebanon is under occupation of Palestine, of Israel. Regarding Palestine, you know, nowadays, no one could stop genocide in Gaza.
I'm saying that Iran has been investing in this machinery of war and of terror, in terrorizing, not just Israel. They are responsible for killing half a million people in Syria. They have taken hostage the state of Lebanon. With the pretext of fighting ISIS, they have created all these militias in Iraq. They have destroyed Yemen. They have destroyed the Middle East. And they are trying to destroy the state of Israel. So what happened is that they failed. They failed colossally because two of their main proxies in the region were defeated by Israel. And now they find themselves having at last to fight themselves. And they are failing. They might have more missiles, but whoever is the aggressor must pay a price. And I'm very glad that many countries around the world have condemned what Iran has been doing. And I'm sure we're going to find a way to send a clear message to this fanatical regime that we will not bear. They made a very big mistake.
The one party who is against every political settlement is the terror state of Israel. Israel has always refused the political solution and has always resorted to military measurements. What happened recently, if we want to talk directly on the current situation, is that, yes, Lebanon has been working with international powers for a ceasefire on the Lebanese front, and to kind of separate it from Gaza front. And there has been, with the good offices of France and the USA even, and some other European powers, There has been a kind of draft agreement to for a ceasefire, ceasing of hostilities. But there was a kind of plot, because even our minister mentioned it, that late Sayyid Hassan Nasrallah himself agreed to a ceasefire. But then the assassination happened, and a kind of breach of trust. Then the whole situation went to square zero.
All right, now let's get to the latest images coming in from this conflict. Israel continues to fight a multi-front war. Let's take a look at the images coming in. Hezbollah's Islamic resistance continues its unwavering efforts to defend Lebanese territories, respond to Israeli brutal aggression, and support the Gaza Strip. Hezbollah forces targeted Israel's Eliakim military site and Nebziv artillery positions in northern occupied Palestine. Israel's military released footage claiming to show the launch of some of at least 180 missiles fired at Israel. The location of the footage was unspecified. Iran said the barrage was retaliation for a series of devastating blows. Israel has landed in recent weeks against the Iran-backed militant group Hezbollah in Lebanon, which has been firing rockets into Israel since the war in Gaza began. Meanwhile, thousands of Yemeni demonstrators took to the streets of the capital Sana'a following Friday prayers to commemorate the death of Lebanese Hezbollah leader Hassan Nasrallah. They also expressed their continued solidarity with Palestinians in the Gaza Strip as the Israel-Hamas war nears its one-year mark. Houthis, Iranian-backed rebels, have been organizing protests since the start of the war. Meanwhile, in Lebanon, hundreds of children have been killed or injured, hundreds of thousands displaced, and countless others at risk due to ongoing hostilities. Thousands of children and families are now living in the streets or in shelters, many having fled their homes without essential supplies and belongings. Humanitarian conditions are growing worse by the hour. An Israeli attack helicopter was seen firing missiles at the Lebanese border, with the country followed by smoke rising from southern Lebanon. Israel also carried out another series of punishing airstrikes, hitting suburban Beirut and cutting off the main border crossing between Lebanon and Syria for tens of thousands of people fleeing the Israeli bombardment of the Hezbollah militant group.